This is a Ford Mustang V8 engine. What does the operation of this car engine depend on? First of all, humanity's knowledge is required to produce this engine. It has been improved every year since the invention of the first engine. Hundreds of engineers have worked on it since its first production. Cylinders, pistons, valves, spark plugs, crankshaft, fuel injectors, many such parts. These parts need to be assembled. It needs gasoline to run. When everything is complete, it works and produces energy. These parts are manufactured to extremely precise measurements. If the diameter of the spark plugs is 2 millimeters wider, or the electrode gap changes slightly, the engine will not start. It wouldn't work if this piece was 1 millimeter larger. If I put diesel instead of gasoline, it still won't work. There is a total order and a perfect ecosystem on Earth. There are thousands of different settings that are more sensitive than an engine. Let's look at some of them. The fundamental building blocks of the entire universe are atoms. The most important settings are at the atomic level, the spin of electrons, the structure of the nucleus, and the differences between all elements depend on these forces. When the universe was created with the Big Bang, four fundamental forces were created. The first is the strong force. If we talk about the power of the strong force, the others are as follows. The electromagnetic force is 10 to the minus 3 power weaker than that. The weak force is 10 to the minus 16th power, which is small. Gravity, or mass, is 10 to the minus 41st power of this. Just as a table stands on four legs, the universe balances on these four forces. The force we know best is the gravitational force. If the gravitational force were a little weaker, for example, if it were 10 to the minus 42 power instead of 10 to the minus 41 power, the planets would be thrown into space and the Earth would not revolve around the Sun. If gravity were greater than it is now, the clouds would disappear and it would no longer rain. Weak force is millions of times weaker than the strong force. If this balance changes, the Sun cannot produce energy. What would happen if the strong force were stronger? The periodic table would be turned upside down. In other words, the universe project would be over from the beginning. This mini-world model works with electromagnetic force, one of these four forces. When electric current comes, electromagnets work and a magnetic field is created. There is no connection at the moment, it is in a void. When the power goes out, the electromagnetic field ends. The other three forces hold matter together with invisible bonds. It continues thanks to these four forces that live on Earth. If the creation outlet is closed, the forces that hold all atoms and atomic particles will be finished. Everything falls apart and turns into dust. There is a different balance of elements on land and in the sea. There is 21% oxygen on land and 34% in the sea. There is 78% nitrogen on land and 62% in the sea. If these ratios were to change places, life would end. But if oxygen decreases, for example, if it falls below 16%, even a match will not light. Nothing catches fire. Ovens don't work. Engines stop. And 16% oxygen is not enough for breathing. We all die. If the carbon dioxide rate increases to 5%, we will have to walk around with a mask. Agricultural lands dry up, and the food chain collapses. The ecosystem on Earth operates depending on the precise ratio of these elements. There are perpetual balances in nature. These balances are as important as the oil in the engine. Just as an engine would not run without oil, life would not continue without these cycles. The most important one is the water cycle. If water did not evaporate, then be stored in the sky, and then fall as rain, life would not continue. In the carbon cycle, plants take in carbon dioxide through photosynthesis. Living things consume foods containing carbon. through respiration and decay, carbon is released back into the atmosphere as carbon dioxide. Animals take nitrogen from plants, take nitrogen, and release it into nature with their waste. Bacteria release nitrogen back into the atmosphere. Phosphorus found in soil and rocks is dissolved by rain, passed on to plants, and then transferred to animals. It returns to the soil with the decay of dead organisms. Life on Earth continues with these cycles. This is our solar system. The sun is the greatest source of life. According to NASA, this is the habitable zone within the solar system. The world is exactly where it should be. If we were close to the sun, we would burn like Mercury or Venus. If we were on Mars and beyond, we would freeze. We are exactly where we need to be. If the sun were smaller, we would be outside the habitable zone. If the sun were to grow twice as large, the habitable zone would be much further away. We are exactly where we need to be, and we are getting exactly the amount of heat and light we need. This balance is never disturbed. The distance between the Earth and the Moon is 380,000 kilometers. What would happen if it was 280,000 instead of 380,000? Tides would intensify, and coastal cities would be flooded. The mass of the Earth is exactly as it should be. If the Earth were to shrink by 20%, it would be the size of Venus. This would affect gravity. The balance in the gravitational atmosphere, atmospheric rain, and the entire ecosystem would be disrupted. The Earth's tilt relative to the solar system is 23.5 degrees, 23.5 degree incline. If this 23.5 degree slope were to be disrupted, say to 45.5 degrees, the climate would be disrupted and the seasons would disappear, 24 hours in a day. What would happen if it was 48 hours instead of 24? If the Earth's rotation speed were halved, a day would be 48 hours. This made it scorching hot during the day and freezing cold at night. Strong winds would create hurricanes. Agricultural production would be at risk. How do these balances work in our engine example? Can I change the size of these pieces? If the angle of the wheel were 85 degrees instead of 90 degrees, the engine would still not work. There is something around the Earth that does not exist on other planets. Protective layers. While the sun produces energy, harmful rays are also released. Solar winds, clouds of charged particles, magnetic plasma fields, beams of radiation, all are hurtling toward the Earth at speeds of 9 million kilometers per hour. Their harmful effects are prevented in the ozone layer. Meteors rain down on Earth every day from the asteroid belt. Some are the size of a grain of wheat. Some are the size of giant rocks. Some approach the Earth at a speed of 40,000 kilometers per hour. Some at a speed of 250,000 kilometers per hour. These meteors are destroyed in the mesosphere layer. What we call shooting stars in the night sky is the fact that the larger ones are dust. Without the mesosphere, we wouldn't be able to walk down the street. The inner layers of the Earth are different, not like other planets. At the center of the Earth, there is molten iron and nickel. There are magma oceans. This metal core turns the Earth into a giant magnet, and it forms another layer, the magnetosphere, that protects the world from harmful rays. If the Earth were not a protected planet, these rays would wipe out the atmosphere. The other planets do not have a magnetosphere, so they do not have a protective magnetic field. This shows that their interior is different from Earth. The Earth has been rotating in the same orbit for centuries, without a second's delay, without changing its orbit. The solar system is under the control of such a power that we can know today what time the sun will rise in the morning 20 years from now. For example, it is already known what time the sun will rise in London in 2045, 20 years from now. This engine represents just one cog in one of the mechanisms that operate throughout the universe. What can I say about the existence and operation of this engine? What conclusions can I draw based on reason and logic? We can say that it was designed by engineers in a factory. We assume that each piece was cast from separate molds. Even though we don't see the engineers in the factory, we never doubt it. This engine consists of 200 parts. What if I said it like this?
These were formed by chance over 100 million years in a metal and plastic scrapyard. Metals were synthesized, combined, and became what they are through chemical and physical reactions.
Even if I said this about a single part of this engine, everyone would laugh. Nobody would believe it. What if I said the same thing about the universe?
The entire universe and the solar system, the world and the order in the world came into being without the need for a creator. It existed without purpose. Everything happened by chance over billions of years. It changed, transformed, and came to the most suitable position for life.
I have primitive photographs of the automobile engine. It has evolved over the years. Is having photos of old models evidence of self-evolution? Looking at these, can I say that this engine has improved itself over time? Can I deny the engineers and designers? We cannot explain existence by ignoring a creator. This creator may have created it all at once, or he may have perfected it step by step. It doesn't matter if this change and transformation is called evolution. If a change has a purpose and aim, if there is a movement towards greater perfection, there is intelligence, power, and consciousness behind it. There is a designer who has an eye on purpose. If we do not accept this, we must be able to explain the evolution of these cars without engineers and designers.